was fifth in the five-star course at the Signal Iduna Cup at Dortmund. And Johnny Oliver also, he rides both ends of the spectrum. He rides a little bit of rodeo as well.
Really? I didn't know that. It's another rider who's in a big improvement. Quite a bit of ground cover for that extended track.
Such a typical Lusitano, this horse, isn't it? It's like one of those sort of copper statues of, you know, a Greek war horse.
With a big neck.
He's from a real sporting background as well. His mother was a basketball medalist at the Atlanta Olympic Games, Hortensia.
That's right. We have a little more bend here in this half pass to the left. Got a lot of expression. Perfectly square. That's the best reinback that we've seen so far. You see that the marks go up as a result.
So what you're seeing there on the screen is the comparison to the leader at this point in the test. Overall, Edwards scored a 74.4.
A slight loss of activity going into the Piave. It recovered very nicely.
Because it was that little bit early, you feel like maybe the horse overreacted to the aid and gave it to Johnny earlier than he expected.
That's right, that's what it looked like. Slight anticipation. And the walk is not the highlight for this horse. Bit of a hurried walk. Can see some tension.
Leif Thornblad just leaning over the desk to see every detail as the walk goes past his booth at M.
Could have a bit more expression in this passage. And again, an early transition. But once in the Piaf, it's a good quality Piaf. And transitions could be clearer coming out as well.
So the horse is initially a little bit inclined to take his front legs back onto the girth, and then actually they improved and straightened out, didn't
correct.
They?
You saw Victor give the horse a little push with his leg there to get him a bit more in front of him. Small mistake there. Covered well.
The annoyance, of course, is that you're getting one single mark for all those exercises, all those flying changes, so the mistake really does bring you down.
A bit hurried in the extended canter. But Victor's riding a very obedient test as much as possible, even though the horse is challenging him a bit here and there. It's having to work a little bit for it today.
Just under his Brazilian flag there, he in fact wears the cap badge of the regiment with which he served on national service in Brazil. It's actually familiar to us as it is the home barracks at the Olympic Equestrian Center, the General Eloy de Menezes Olympic Equestrian Center in Deodoro in Rio.
Clean one, Tempies. And a little slight loss of activity in that canter pirouette. Although the size was good. And same thing with this one.
It'd be sort of interesting when you compare and contrast. They have to show one canter pirouette each way in their freestyle. And some riders, you know, they know their horses are brilliant at it. They come straight out of the halt into a double pirouette. And then some riders, they just show the bare minimum. You see whether Johnny's had an off day today or whether that's just not one of this horse's strong suits.
That was the best extended trot, though, of the ride, that last trot extension.
Just ground a little bit to a halt in the transition.
That's right. The quality of the Piaf in this horse is very good, though. Transitions need a bit of work today.
Definitely, Piaf Passage should play to a Lusitano horse's strengths, and seems to do so today for Johnny Victor, Macri Oliva, and Ziama de Pines for Brazil. The Brazilian Olympian.